Do not adjust your televisual setup device. These are actual pictorial photostats of Anthony Rooney and Lucy Stapleton in the 1980s. Gasp at the revolting haircuts and hideous clothes, and then gaze at the head table in this very room and marvel at how wonderful they both look today on their wedding day. Join me, Reginald Winthrop, as I delve into the filthy details of Anthony and Lucy's beautiful journey to this spellbinding day.
Anthony and Lucy, a love story. Almost a decade in the making. Hello, my name is Reginald Winthrop, and I've been tasked with dissecting this grandiose tale of romance. And where better to start than where it all began for our two lovebirds.
Shankill! Shan, from the ancient Gaelic word meaning old, and kill from the word for murder. A picturesque suburb of Bray.
It's Dublin. It's County Dublin.
Dublin? But that is bloody miles away! Stapleton Manor. The humble lodgings where the beautiful Lucy spent much of her youth. Actually, all of her youth. And her adult life. It's now home to both Anthony and Lucy, along with their dazzlingly splendid and endearing offspring, Luca.
Love you, Mum.
Bray! Often referred to as the Brighton of Ireland. Albeit with a far inferior homoerotic scene. A suburb of Dublin.
It's Wicklow. It's County Wicklow.
Wicklow? But everyone has a bloody Dublin accent!
The royal residence of the Rooney clan. Living quarters for Anthony while he grew into the man we see today. And now home to, quite frankly, a frightening amount of female Rooneys.
It is here where Anthony's most treasured childhood memories were born. Then we discussed the new, joyful memories being created with his bride Lucy and their sweet, charming heir, Luca.
Love you, Mum.
In the lead up to this joyous day, I took the time to sit down with groom Anthony and hear the fascinating story of how these two rambunctious lovebirds met, and learn of the moments in their time together that will always have a special place in their hearts.
As ruler of this roost, Anthony, I'd like to thank you for your hospitality.
You're welcome.
And of course, let me decorate this room with the appropriate decor.
That's not permanent, is it?
I'm also grateful for you allowing me to unravel this rich tapestry of your adoring love for the lovely Lucy.
More than welcome, Reginald. May I call you Reginald?
No.
Right, fair enough so. I don't need any cheers to talk about Lou.
Who I love, by the way.
So let's dig a little deeper and probe your romantic side, Anthony. Share with me, if you will, your fondest memories with the love of your life, Lucy.
Well, okay, there have been so many happy memories for me. Every day better than the last. But if I had to pick out particular highlights, there's probably four moments that especially stand out for me.
Please, elaborate, if you will.
Well, there's only one place to start. When I first set eyes on Lucy. In you, from that moment, we belong together.
Ooh.
We were all obsessed. These girls were like movie stars to us. We'd never seen girls so beautiful. Mutant-like faces couldn't win them over, then maybe our pathetic, underdeveloped charm might give us the edge.
So, it was from that moment on, and the years that followed, that you really got to know the future love of your life.
Yeah, that's basically it. I mean, there was times we lost touch, we had separate things going on in our lives, but Lucy never, well, she never left my thoughts.
Fascinating!
So after a few years, I eventually plucked up the courage and I asked her out. To my amazement, she said yeah.
Magnificent! So it all began. You courted for a couple of years, allowing this love to bloom. But was there a specific moment where you thought, this is it? She is the one!
Yeah, funny you should say it. I also involved the other love of my life, Manchester United. I'll never forget that day.
It was Manchester Derby, 2009. I think it was Lucy's first taste of watching the big match with me. So seeing me cursing and going mad at the TV, probably it being a deal breaker. City pulled one back, to 3-3 in the last minute. I was raging. But, typical United, in Fergie time, they won it. 4-3. What a result. I always knew it, but I think that was the moment I properly realised Lucy is the one. I was a very, very happy man, which was helped by the fact that United had just beaten City in injury time.
Night now.
Well, thank you for your candidly disgusting depiction of your lovemaking skills. Despite the horror, we've segued nicely to the next sizable moment in your lives. The conception, which we have covered in grisly detail, and eventual birth of your resplendent child, Luca.
Look, it was a game changer for us. We didn't exactly plan it, but listen, my God, we wouldn't change that little guy for the world.
I remember being serenely calm in the room. Lucy was an absolute trooper. Wasn't a bother to her. A beautiful bird. Lucy was my hero that day. She still is. She delivered the gift of Luca with aplomb.
So, this aforementioned miracle was the final piece in the Anthony and Lucy, or Lucani, puzzle of poetic passion.
Look, he's the greatest little guy I have ever known. There are many, many reasons myself and Leo would belong together. But bringing this little fella into the world shows the proof. He's our greatest triumph and he's our future. But there was still one little piece I needed to put in place to make our magical journey complete.
Fascinating, fascinating. And precisely, what was the final throw of the dice, Anthony?
It was time. It's time to show my love and my commitment for my true love.
Hmm.
I took Lucy away for a romantic weekend in Paris for her birthday, and to a U2 concert. Where better than the most romantic city on earth to ask for Lucy's hand? Lucky for me, she said yes. We've come a long, long way since we first set eyes on each other in Jim Doyle's nearly 20 years ago, but Lucy agreed to make me the happiest man alive. My life was almost complete.
Staggering! And when you mentioned before, your life was almost complete. Anthony, what did you mean by that?
Well, Reggie, can I call you Reggie?
Good God, man! Now,
well, Reg, my life will be finally complete when I can call Lucy my wife. Everything, and I mean everything, has been leading to that point. As soon as I laid eyes on Lucy, I knew we were destined to be together. Fate followed that path, and together we've loved and lived for so many happy years. We've been blessed with a wonderful little son who's loved and adored by all. So we've shared so many amazing memories, and I'm so, so excited to share more with Lucy as my wife. Lucy, you are my everything, and I love you.
I thank you today for your time, Anthony. But if you just excuse me for a moment, my eyes appear to be a little sweaty. Turn the camera off! Where's my bloody glasses, you fool?
As I stood gazing over the vast wilderness plains of Saligap, a cherished haven for Anthony and Lucy, I couldn't help but be in awe of the beauty and splendor before my eyes. A fitting metaphor for Anthony and Lucy's relationship, I'm sure you'll all agree. As we celebrate together this story of love, thank you, one and all, for being part of this special day. And so we close the opening chapter of Anthony and Lucy's enchanting yarn. This story is only just beginning. The adventure starts here, and I, for one, look forward to sharing in all the happy memories in all of the years to come. I've been Reginald Winthrop. You've been ravishing. I'll see you on the dance floor. She's a mystery.
In the night of love, words tangled in her hair, words soon to disappear. A love so sharp. Like a switchblade to my heart, words tear.